We have season. We have season. We have season. We have season. We have season.
Back there. We don't even know.
You know, man.
Good morning. Can't see all of you too well, but I'm sure you're looking very beautiful this morning. Welcome to Summit Church. If you're a visitor here, I want to encourage you to fill out the visitor card you found in your seat. Just put it in the offering bucket when it's passed around later. So, some things to look forward to. June 12th, which is that next week? Two weeks from now, is our one-day VBS. So, if you have kids, we look forward to seeing you there. There's also a flyer for it in the back if you want some more information on the table in the back. Be sure to look for that. June 25th, we will be helping out Claremont Baptist Church, kind of picking up the pastorium there, and that'll be June 25th, so there'll be a sign-up sheet next week, so we'll be looking forward to that, and let's take this opportunity to serve our brothers. And June 26th, we'll have a baptism, so if you'd like more information on that, or maybe being baptized, there's some information in the back as well. So last week, we talked about GROW, which was, time of personal devotion, time of prayer, corporate worship, and things like that. So this week I want to talk about go, and give. And so in the book of Ephesians, Paul is talking to the Ephesians, and they're Gentiles, right? Which means they're not Jews. And when I read Gentiles in the Bible, my ears kind of perk up because I'm like, they're talking about me, okay? And he's talking about this mystery, okay? That, you know, the covenants of promise were given to the Hebrews, you know, way back in the day. But now Paul is talking, well, you know, you were strangers and you were aliens, but he says now through the blood of Christ, you are no longer strangers or aliens, but you have been brought near. And then he says, when he's talking about the gospel, he says, of this gospel, I was made a minister according to the gift of God's grace, which was given to me by the working of his power, to me, though I'm the very least of all the saints, to preach to the Gentiles the unsearchable riches of Christ. It's so beautiful and so profound, this message that we preach. So we share in the ministry of Paul to preach to everyone the unsearchable riches of Christ. So I encourage you to go, invite your friends to Summit, let them share this fellowship with us. Share your faith, we all have a story to tell. Thank you so much for being here. Let's worship together. Thank you. that you would fill us with an awareness of your presence. God, we know that you are good. We know that you are trustworthy, that you are faithful. God, we just want to lift all of those things to you this morning. Tell you exactly who you are. To give praise to your name. To thank you for what you've done in our lives. And to commit ourselves to living for you. To living out your gospel. God, please just move in us and among us during this time. In this next song, we just want to take an opportunity to give back to God. As the Bible tells us, we have freely received, therefore we should always freely give. So let's do that as we sing.
Who, oh. We're going to give you that opportunity. We've got brochures in the back if you'd like to take one of those and tell them about baptism, what it means, what's expected, how we do it. We do believe in immersion. So that'll be 26th, okay? So you may know that. Let's just go to God in prayer, right? Lord, I thank you for those that are here today. And Lord, I know that there's so much in life that can disappoint us, that can knock us off track, Lord. They can give us feelings of bitterness and, Lord, feelings of being left out. Lord, sometimes we get knocked off course and we just don't get back on. Lord, I pray there'd be some here today that would make that course adjustment. And Lord, that they would get back right. Lord, that you'd work in their heart, work in their lives. God, that they would make a commitment to live in the freedom which you have given them. Lord, we know there's no freedom in worldliness. There's no freedom in bitterness. There's no freedom in unforgiveness. God, those things only bring bondage. And I pray that people today would experience that freedom that's available. And I pray and ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Got a little something special I'm going to have to take care of right here. And just give y'all the opportunity to be a part of this. Did anybody hear those storms that came through? I think it was Thursday night. Yeah. Thunder and lightning and rain and all that stuff. It was kind of bad. It reminded me of back when it flooded a couple of years ago. But what was seemed to be only 10 minutes, I remember a couple of years ago when it flooded, it lasted all night like that with the heavy thunder and lightning and rain and all that stuff. But little Jay Carnegie was supposed to participate in his kindergarten graduation, and they were not able to get out of the driveway. He's waiting for me. And he was not able to go to his graduation. So we figured, Julie called, and we're going to let him come up here. Julie's going to come up here. And Julie, are you going to say anything, or are you just going to hand him his diploma? You feel free to say what you need to say, and Jake's going to walk across the stage, and Jake's going to get his diploma, okay? They were not able to get out of their driveway because of the storm that knocked down a power line, and they were not able to get out of their driveway to go to the graduation. And so Jake's going to graduate, get his diploma today, and we're going to participate in that.
We just wanted to take this public opportunity to recognize what a great son that we had, and how we're proud of all his accomplishments that he has achieved this year. And if you walk over here, I'll give you a diploma, baby.
grand, Miss Blue.
Long drive back. Let's get his bag. Let's
back. We'll be back. We'll be back next Sunday.
I won't be here next Sunday.
Well, actually, you may not be here next Sunday. I may be here next Sunday.
Okay, I'll come and let me clean up.
I'll be on the town.